I've even been in a meeting in an office whereby the client's like, "Now, Chris, leave." And there's like five people there, and I'm just like so embarrassed. I'm like so hurt.
Welcome back to another episode of the Black Excellence series. So guys, if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, make sure that you click the button below. Don't be a bystander, be a part of the revolution. So guys, let's hop straight into it. Who are you? Where do you come from? What do you do?
My name is Chris Kazadi. I'm the founder and CEO of Click Media Productions. So we specialize in digital and social media marketing. And I'm just a young 26-year-old guy. Grew up in Johannesburg and started my company 3 years ago.
I've always wanted to have my own company. Growing up, I've always wanted to work for myself and just do something for myself. It's always been me. In 2016, in January, that's when I actually started Click Media. So in December, the whole was December, November, I was like, ready. I'm like, 2016, I'm working myself.
Right.
And came Jan, 2016, 20th of Jan. I went to Pretoria to the where they register the companies.
Yeah.
I was there in the queue. I'm like, okay, cool, I'm out here and I wanna start this and I have my own company, and I had the name in my head. Mm. Then when I went there, I just registered and the rest been history.
So in the time of you going to register for your business, What did you have a job? Were you studying? What were you doing at the time?
So basically, it's actually crazy, right? I actually never went to varsity. I never went to varsity. So I got to a point where after high school, I was actually supposed to go to the States for basketball, to play basketball, because I used to play basketball.
Oh, you're an athlete?
Yeah.
Wow, yeah. Word, okay.
So like, I used to play basketball, I was very, very good at basketball. So it's got to a point whereby, you know, with all this, in order for you to travel, you also need money.
Right.
Know, for all this expense in order for you to get to the States. And it got to a point whereby my family didn't have that money, like all the expenses that you need to travel that time. And then I got a chance, I even had a bursary at it used to be called MGI in Midrand. So I had a bursary at MGI to study. It was a basketball bursary, but then it wasn't 100%. So the other money that I had to pay, I still couldn't afford it. My family still couldn't afford it. So I couldn't go to school. So straight from there, I started working for a sports company. So what they were doing sports events and all these things. So I was more specialized on social media, just handling the social media, making sure the posting, all these things on social media.
Right.
Yeah, so that's when I actually fell in love with social media, understanding how it actually works. So while a lot of people are catching up on social media in 2019, I've been like, oh, this is like 2013. I know like what's going on.
Right.
I know the numbers, how to calculate all these numbers, all those things. So it's just something that like I knew in me. And when it came to 2016 came through, like now I was ready to start my own company.
Right.
And yeah.
The average person would rather stick to employment because, you know, salary every month is comfortable and stuff like that. Still, for you to make that leap, and start your own business, leave your job, is crazy. How did you plan that in terms of like, did you think about, okay, financially,
parts.
I'm standing here, this is where I'm going to stay, this is what I'm going to do, how are you going to sustain yourself?
Yeah, so for people that are watching this, actually knew me from 3-4 years ago. I used to work in the club. I used to be a club promoter. During the day, I'll go to my proper 9-to-5, then at night, on weekends, I'll go to the club. So the club money is the money I started saving, because I already knew in my head, I'm like, I was just planning it, like, there will be a time where I won't be doing this, and when I start doing my own company,
right.
I already had a backup, which is the club, which is like, it wasn't paying that much at that time, but then I knew exactly, because I knew what I wanted. Whatever I was getting from that, I made, like, and like I kept the money, I knew what I needed the money for.
Right.
So by the time I left my work, and I started working for myself, I started approaching clients, speaking to people. Whoa, that was like, yo, the hardest part. Woo! Getting people to believe in you, like, okay, cool, this guy can actually handle your work.
Right.
That was one of the trickiest ones.
Talk more about that, about like, how did you find people to approach? How did you start? How did you get them to believe in you?
Yeah, so one of the earliest thing I did is the ball up 3-on-3, the basketball events.
Right.
I remember I played basketball, so I had a lot of basketball friends, I knew a lot of people in the basketball community. When I started ball up 3-on-3, I legit, like, if a lot of basketball are watching, the basketball players are watching this, they got back to their DMs in 2016. I was DMing a lot of basketball players in the country, like the ones that knew me because of the basketball, and
a lot
of basketball mutual friends. Like, I DM them like, yo, please come to my event, yo, please come to my event, please make a team, come to my event, come to my event. Like, I legit DM like a lot of players, like DM, phone call, because I knew if all the players come out to the event and I create that hype and I just invite all the people to come together and experience that whole basketball event, that's when I was gonna pull out Click Media and be like, this event organized by Click Media, and people are asking, who's Click Media? Chris's company, this is what they do. You see, so you couldn't just come out like, nah, Click Media is what you do, is what you do. So I had to do a basketball event. And then when everybody came, so it was called Ball Up, Click Media Presents Ball Up 3-on-3.
Right.
So Ball Up 3-on-3 is the event. People asked me, what's Click Media? Click Media Presents Ball Up 3-on-3. And then they put 2-on-2 together.
I get that, yeah.
So 2-on-2 that I've been pitching people, and people say Click Media, Click Media, Click Media. So, yeah.
That comes with a lot of rejection.
Yeah.
How did you deal with that? You know, rejection hurts, guys. No matter who you are, it hurts.
Yeah.
How did you manage to deal with that rejection and honestly push yourself up to keep going?
So I have this thing in my head, like, I know where I'm going to be. And I've already seen, like, a vision, like, a picture of myself. Mm. Like, in 3 years, in 5 years, I've seen, like, where I'm going to be and who I'm going to be.
Right.
So all those things that are, like, all the things, like, the rejections and all those things, I just think, like, of as obstacles that are trying to stop me to get gay.
Right.
So I already know where I'm going. So all this, when I wake up in the morning, something happens, I already know. Okay, cool. So you're one of the obstacles trying to stop me from getting there. Okay, right. I already know you, so I know how to tackle you. So all those things, like, I've even been in a meeting in an office made by the clients, like, now Chris, leave. And there's, like, five people there, and I'm just, like, so embarrassed. I'm, like, so hurt. But then it's just a thing of, I cool, but then one day you will call me back.
Mm.
And it's like for real, one day you will come back because you don't understand my service now, you don't understand social media, but then it's cool. 3 years from now, 2 years from now, you will come back. You'll be like, remember what you did for me? I need it now. And if you've noticed, a lot of people are going into social media, a lot of marketing, a lot of money is invested in social media marketing.
Yeah.
Instead of most of the traditional marketing. So yeah, and that's where the world is going. Everybody's gonna need social media marketing. Somehow you're gonna need someone to handle your social media, someone to handle social media accounts. You're gonna need someone to handle your company social media account because you gotta do your work and you can't now be on social media if you gotta bring in your work. So we come in and we handle the social media account to see eventually all the companies, everybody's gonna need that one day. And Click Media, we started there. Like, I knew that from 2013 when I started into this, and I just going into the different things, social media management, promoting artists, Ball Up 3-on-3, it's a basketball event,
right.
And all those things, yeah, they're all linked into digital marketing and digital and social media, and it's all linked around Click Media.
There is a huge misconception that entrepreneurship is easy. You sleep all day, do what you want to do. As a young man in business, what are some of the sacrifices that you had to make for the sake of business?
Yo, it's crazy. It's crazy. I made a lot of sacrifices. Like, time. Time was one of them. Like, my time, like, you can even see, like, from my friends. There was a part where my friends even knew, like, Chris doesn't show with us anymore. Because, like, my mindset, there was a time where my mindset just changed. It was just business mode.
Right.
And if you're chilling with me, if you're not talking about business, how are we going to make money? We're just not really going to talk, because now when you tell me something, I reply different. I'm like, yo, dog, I'm trying to do this, I'm trying to do this. So even the environment, like, some of, like, the people I was around, I started, like, not being close to some of my friends because of my mindset and the way I wanted things to go, because I had a vision, like, yo, this is Chris, that's the real, because I didn't know which I'm trying to be like that guy.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So that, and even my relationship, like, my relationship, it was also affected by that, because I was always busy, you know, all these meetings and stuff like that was affected too. And it's just, yeah, time is one of the most important, time with my friends, time with my family, and just even time to go out, you know, things that I used to do before, even basketball, like one of the biggest sacrifices, that because I love basketball. If you go, like, my Facebook naming from 2009 when I had Facebook to, like, 2013, my Facebook name was Chris LeBron Kazani. Everybody knew me as Chris LeBron.
Right.
So I was like that basketball guy, like, preach basketball, everything.
Right.
I have not to stop playing basketball as much as I used to, just so I can just focus on my business, just focus on Click Media. So I took all of my basketball energy and I invested it into Click Media. So so you can tell my energy is strong, because if I left it in basketball, I'd still be up. I think if I had the opportunity that a lot of other kids had at that time, like, if I had someone that was going to pay for my things to go to the States, oh, I promise you, I was gonna, like, ball out, because that was, like, in my heart. So when I couldn't get that, I took all of that energy. I'm like, cool, I'm gonna make Click Media big, so that one day when they ask me, why are you not in the NBA, and I'm gonna reply and be like, because Click Media, that's where all my energy is at right now.
Heard you. There are plenty of companies who do what you do.
Yeah.
With more experience than you and whatnot. What do you do differently? What is your unique something that you offer that makes clients come to you and stay with you?
Come to me and stay with me. So what I do is that I do a good job. So what I mean by that is that when I take your work, for instance, if you are a client and you sell shoes and you want to sell shoes and you want profit on your shoes, and you come to me and we do the marketing, the marketing plan and everything.
Right.
The way I take that work, I take it like it's mine, like now it's my shoes. So like I'm selling my shoes. So now I give it like all my heart. Like if you ever go down to ClickMeet and some of the clients and everyone that I ever worked with, you'd actually think that's actually mine, but it's not. It's a client's work.
Right,
you know what
right.
I'm saying? Because I put in so much work, people started to believe this thing belongs to Chris because I treat like my baby and I'm trying to make sure you get a tough and you get whatever you came to me for.
Right.
So that's what I mean also by doing a good job, because whatever you give me, I got to do a good job. I can't disappoint you. So I try my best. By the time I wake up in the morning, I do a good job. When I go to sleep at night, I must make sure I did a good job with whatever client that came to me. Most of my clients are usually from referrals. Like if I do a work for you, be like, yo, that guy did that for me. Because it's either you tell them or someone asks you, who did that for me? Like Chris,
right.
And Chris and Chris and Chris. It's more of referrals and just doing a good job. Because I think that's the best way to actually market yourself is doing a good job. You can't screw people over. Even if I screw you over, you don't see, God sees. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And
yeah.
I don't want to be in trouble with God. So
that
I just do
true.
A good job and I just make sure. Yeah.
What advice do you have for the young man or woman who is currently in the position that you were in, wherein you couldn't afford to go to school? What advice do you have for the young man or woman who's just started business or, you know, wants to start a business?
The first advice I'll give to them is just be dedicated to whatever you are doing. Mm. So put dedication and focus and believe in whatever you're doing, because a lot of people don't believe at the beginning, like, no, come on, do this, but when things start failing, they start losing hope and faith and everything
right.
like that. So believe in whatever you're doing. If you believe in it and you see yourself in the future, that's one of the biggest things. Just see yourself in the future, imagine yourself in the future and work towards that.
Right.
Yeah.
Something I like doing
mm-hmm.
with all my interviews is I have a bowl here,
okay.
tongue twisters.
Okay.
And you have 30 seconds to pick one, read it or recite it,
uh-huh.
and then you have to read it as fast as you can.
Okay.
All right. Okay. Cool. Let me get the time.
So I have to read it as fast as I can.
As fast as you can, like a tongue twister. You ready?
Okay.
In 3, 2, 1, go. It's a thick one.
Peter Piper picked a pick of pickled papers. A peck of pickled papers Peter Piper picked.
What the hell? Can you say that again and say it faster?
Peter Piper picked a peck of pickled papers. A peck of pickled papers Peter Piper picked.
Oh my gosh. Wow. Okay. Black excellence, everybody. Black excellence.
Hey guys, Chris Kazari, founder and CEO of Click Media Productions, and you are watching Black Excellence with Benita Daniela.
That's it for today. I hope you liked this video. Don't forget to comment, like, share, and
subscribe.
I will be back with more videos.